We have Jervis Manahan, who joins us from Camarines Sur. Of course, we know Bicol region is one of the hardest hit. Jervis, hi. Go ahead. What do you have for us?
Yes, good morning, Michelle. Hundreds of passengers are stranded in Limanan, Camarines Sur for 2 days already since their buses cannot pass through flooded areas in Bicol region. They said they have been stuck for 2 days since Tuesday with barely enough to eat, and they haven't took a bath since. They will have to wait until the flood subsides. Passengers are asking for rescue trucks so they could go to their destinations in other areas in Bicol region, like Sorsogon. Meanwhile, Michelle, the weather is a little better today with just cloudy skies. It rained a bit this morning, but it didn't last long. We are still trying to make our way to Nabuay, Camarines Sur, and some parts of Albay, but roads are still not passable. Michelle.
Jervis, are the floodwaters starting to go down? I mean, when are we expecting these roads to finally be usable?
Some of the areas, Michelle, have seen some floods in some areas in Camarines Sur have subsided, but some parts of the highway are still possible. So we are still checking if we can make it through other parts of Camarines Sur and Albay this morning.
All right. I imagine health is also of primary importance as we speak. Leptospirosis comes top of mind.
Yes, there are some clinics or some community doctors that were giving out medicines in some of the evacuation centers yesterday, but we are not sure if all evacuation centers were giving medicines for leptospirosis. So we'll have to check that today, Michelle, because the priority yesterday was just for evacuation and survival of the residents here in Bicol region.
And when you talk to the locals there, those who are affected, the thousands who are evacuated, are they giving you a timeline when they expect to go back to their homes, start cleaning up if they still have homes to go back to?
Well, yesterday, Michelle, in Sipokot, some of the residents have already started going back to their homes because the first town that we have visited yesterday in Sipokot, floods have already subsided there. But we are checking other hardly hit areas in Camarines Sur if that's the same case. We're just hoping that the weather will continue to improve by today so that the flood will eventually subside and that they can go back to their homes. But they are not yet sure, really, that the residents are so uncertain as to when they could go back home. But those in areas that are not so affected have started cleaning up their homes already.
And when you talk to the locals, maybe even government officials there, what is the general sense that you're getting? Do they feel like they were caught off guard, that they didn't expect the impact of Christine to be this much? Is this something that, you know, will merit being in a superlative? Is this the biggest flood that they've seen in X number of years, something that they're not used to really?
Yes, Michelle, because they have told us, you have talked to some of the residents since yesterday, and they said that while they're used to typhoons, this one is not really normal because the Bicol River has really overflowed, and that caused massive flooding. Most of the residents here have second floors in their homes, and they did not expect that the water would reach the second floors of their homes. So they really had to evacuate. So they say that they are used to typhoons, but this one is stronger and it brought more water. They likened it to Typhoon Ulysses back in 2020 because some of the areas here are not really flood-prone, but they've seen floods because of Typhoon Christine over the past few days.
All right. Thank you very much for bringing us the latest update there from Camarines Sur. Jervis, please do take care. Keep safe. Going back now to Izzy Lee, who joins us for the latest situation in Rizal. Hi, Izzy. Go ahead.
Michelle, earlier this morning, a tree fell along Tanay-Pililla Road, causing only one lane to be passable to motorists. The winds are very strong this morning here in Panay, Rizal. However, barangay officials have already cleared the fallen tree. According to the Rizal provincial government, the province remains under signal number 2. Stronger rains and winds are being experienced in the eastern part of Rizal, including Panay, Pililla, Halahala, and Morong. As of 6 a.m., water levels in Wawa Dam and San Mateo River are still below critical levels, but are continuously being monitored by the Rizal Provincial Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Office, or or PDRRMO. Main roads like Marcos Highway, Sumulong Highway, and others are still passable and free from flooding. According to the latest report from PDRRMO, 183 families or more than 600 individuals have been evacuated from 13 barangays as a preemptive measure. The 24-hour operation of DRRMC is activated and evacuation centers in each town of Rizal are prepared. Rescue personnel are also on standby for deployment if needed. Michelle?
So, Izzy, just to clarify, the rains have started to ease. The winds are strong, but the rains have started to ease. And the water level there is not within critical levels, correct?
Yes, Michelle, that's correct. The water levels are below critical level as of the moment because the rain here in Rizal is only from light to moderate, but the winds in some of the areas like in Tanay are very, very strong. Michelle?
All right, because everybody's really watching Rizal closely as well to see what happens in Marikina, because as we know, higher levels at the Marikina River usually comes from upstream flow or water coming down from Rizal's mountainous areas. So we're really keeping a close eye. Thank you so much for joining us for an update. Izzy Lee there, joining us on the line. Do keep safe. At least 14 people have been reported dead while thousands are evacuated due to severe tropical storm Christine, the 11th cyclone to hit the country this year, affecting nearly the entire Luzon and Visayas and parts of Mindanao, the Bicol region. Among the hardest hit where many areas remain submerged in water. The nonstop rains also caused lahar flow from the Mayon volcano. Now, Christine made landfall over Divilacan, Isabela past midnight and as of 5 this morning has gradually decelerated while moving northwestward over northern Luzon. Several provinces in northern Luzon have been placed under signal number 3, while Metro Manila and a dozen others are under signal number 2. Incessant rains brought by severe tropical storm Christine have triggered landslides and severe flooding across the Philippines. About 5 million people in the typhoon-hit areas are without power, and parts of the national highway have become waterlogged. The National Disaster Management Office reports nearly 300 roads and bridges are now impassable due to flooding. In Isabela, where Christine made landfall earlier today, 7 bridges have already overflowed. Crops also devastated by floods. 4 are meanwhile reported dead in Catanduanes due to a landslide in Caramoran. Mindanao also not spared by the wrath of Christine. About 3,000 families in Maguindanao del Sur were displaced due to the floods. Data from the NDRRMC show more than 2 million individuals have been affected by the storm, while 18 cities and municipalities have also been placed under a state of calamity. The Social Welfare Department, meanwhile, vows the government is on top of the situation.
Na national stockpile of family food packs ng DSWD ay nasa mahigit 1.9 million dahil nga before Christine ay nasa mahigit 2 million ito, but since we've already started augmenting the resources of the local government units, particularly in the Bicol region, nabawasan na po yung stockpile natin. However, ongoing pa rin naman yung ating production doon sa major hub na total humanitarian assistance already extended by the DSWD is more than 55 million pesos na po.
A price freeze on basic commodities now in effect in areas under a state of calamity due to severe tropical storm Christine. This is according to the Philippine Trade Department. So far, only the province of Albay and the town of Magpet in Cotabato province have been placed under a state of calamity. Other flood-ravaged areas have yet to declare. Now, under a state of calamity, a 60-day automatic price freeze is imposed on key commodities such as canned fish, instant noodles, bottled water, and bread. The agency is now monitoring prices and supply levels of products in all affected areas. Now, the Pharmaceutical and Healthcare Association of the Philippines warns of possible delays in replenishing stocks to pharmacies affected by Christine. This is due to widespread floods and impassable roads. BHAP assures, however, that there are still adequate stocks of crucial medicines for colds, cough, and flu throughout the country, and its member companies continue to operate amid the storm. Philippine transport regulators have released 1,200 special permits allowing public utility vehicles to operate beyond their usual routes during All Saints and All Souls Day. This is the LTFRB anticipates a spike in travelers during the Undas break. The special permits will enable more PUVs to serve routes as far south as Bicol and as far north as Cagayan and Lawag. Also in transport news, the LTFRB reports 700 additional PUV operators have applied for the controversial PUV modernization program after registration reopened this month. Officials expect up to 10,000 more operators and drivers to join the program by the end of the extended registration period this November 29. More Filipinos now turning to online shopping for buying their gifts and other essentials for Christmas. Analytics firm Kantar Philippines reports, while the majority of Filipino shoppers still buy from brick-and-mortar stores, there has been a noticeable shift toward online shopping, which began during the height of the COVID-19 pandemic. Kantar attributes this increase to relative ease of shopping on online platforms.
We're actually seeing that there's seasonality, no, pagdating sa pagbili online. Actually, that also is the case when it comes to offline. You feel yan when you go to malls. Pero based on our data, we're seeing na online platforms are really also, increasing their sales. Especially ngayon, may mga 11-11 and 12-12, no. We're seeing that the spike in the shopper sales are coinciding with this.
TikTok Shop Philippines supports the view, noting that its number of online sellers has doubled year on year, with most sellers coming from the Gen Z cohort.